Hello, today I'm going to show you the user experience with ABBYY FlexiCapture, the distributed version. Now, the whole user experience within the distributed version is strictly within the what we call the verification station. Every other experience in the solution is administrative. So in this case, though, the user is going to simply open the verification station, which can be done multiples of ways. We can simply look for it within the start menu, which is what we'll do in this case, where you can, of course, find it within the file structure as well. So we're going to open the verification station where we will live as a user, and we're going to select the project that we're opening to manage this time. And in this case, we're going to stick with our banking project. At this point, we select the role. Now, it's very typical that a user get assigned to one role. If a user is assigned to multiple roles, they will get this box, but it's actually very common a user doesn't see this box because they're assigned to one role. There are different uses of these roles that you can find in the help menu, but the one with the highest level of permissions is the senior verification operator, and that's the one that we're going to use today. When we load up the screen, we have this view of queues. Now, there can be a number of different queues in the software. In this case right now, we have two. We have what we call a verification queue, and we have an exceptions queue. The purpose of the exceptions queue is that if there is an error within the software from processing the document, then we don't ever want to lose where that document is or the data that is along with that document. So we put those in exception queues. But other than that, business operating queues are typically verification queues, and then, of course, a whole list of other verification queues that you can have or custom queues that you can create. But out of the box, there are just two, and, of course, all of this is configurable. The first thing we will do is we will select the queue, which is we're going to keep verification selected, and we're going to hit our Get Task button. Now, using a round robin approach, the software will grab the next available task that is available to me to verify, and now we will simply go through every file within this task and look at the results. Now, I'm going to move this up just a little bit so we get more of the screen, and I'm going to fit this here to a width so we can see everything. So what we have here on this screen is that we have four different documents that we need to verify before I can be finished with this task. And what we're going to do is, like I said, double click on them, and we will compare all of the results on the left side of the screen, which is what the software extracted it, to a copy of the image or the document on the right side of the screen. And we simply work our way through here, correcting anything that we need to correct. Now, the software has this idea of a confidence level. And confidence level strictly is its own confidence that what it extracted for a given character is correct. And anything that has a lack of confidence will show as red here. And so what we need to do is anything in red or anything, frankly, that is wrong, we need to correct before we process it so that we can get the best and correct data. If for some reason there is a wrong character, then we just simply need to override that and hit enter, and the software will use that character or those new fixed characters that we just typed as the new results. So it will never keep that bad result in there for us. And we would just want to verify these kind of this data that we extract. Now, in handwriting, we will have more verification than what we would if there was just a nice clean text version of this form. So that's all we do. And you can kind of see here, we would just work our way through here and move on. And to move on, we simply click the next one. It will ask us if we want to save the results, and of course we do. And we can opt not to show this, and the software will save them by default. And we would simply work through the verification process. So for example, we have some names that aren't matching. There are three pages of this document, and therefore there are three names that need to match, and they're not matching. And the software is asking us to compare those and make sure that what it extracted is correct. So it looks correct there, it looks correct here, and in this one here we want to correct. Okay, and then of course our errors go away. And that's simply what we would do throughout the processing side of it. Now at this point, when we are done with the document, typically, to move the document into the next stage of the workflow, all we would do is hit close task. Now, it's very common that when we hit the close task, the document does two things. It will export the data and export the document itself. However, that's not always the case. There is different workflow processes that we can put into place so that when we are done with this stage, we can send the document and the data to different stages. So at this point, the software is 100% customizable to your business process. Not all of our solutions work the exact same way. Not all of our customers use it the exact same way. So this is 100% customizable and flexible to your business process. But in the case that we want to be done with this, all we need to do to get it out of our queue when we are done working it is to hit the close task button. When we hit the close task button, it's going to ask me, hey, since there are still some items in red, it's going to ask me if I want to go back to those. To speed up this, we're going to say no. And what the software will do is move that document to the next step in the workflow. And it is as that simple. And all I would need to do to get the next task is to hit the Get Task button, and it will load the next batch of documents for me to verify. It's a very clean process. All the user's experience is within our verification station here. It's a very powerful tool, and there are unique different keyboard shortcuts even to make the process even faster for the user. So, that's how simple the user experience here is within the software. If you have any questions, please reach out to us. We'd love to be of assistance to you. Thank you so much for watching this video.